Hi, everybody. This is Crystal Proxmire of Oakland County Times. And we're here today with Ferndale Mayor Melanie Piana, who's running for re-election. How are you today?
I'm great. Thanks for having me and always doing candidate videos. It's really important what you do.
Thanks. Can you tell us how long have you been mayor for?
I have been mayor for almost 2 years. I was elected in November 2019, and in Ferndale, we don't take our seats right away, and I was sworn in of January 2020.
So in the time that you've been mayor and on council, what are some of the things that you're most proud of?
Well, I'm most proud of how our community and our city staff and city council responded to the pandemic health crisis. We've never had any experience with such a pandemic health crisis. And so all of us are learning, adapting, adjusting on the go. And I know that was an exhaustive and stressful experience for all of us. You know, local governments don't have a lot of powers around health, when, particularly like Ferndale, the size, we don't have a health department. So we had to figure out how to be a great partner with Oakland County in making sure residents had timely and accurate information, not only about the disease, COVID disease, but also when vaccines came available, and making sure people were getting access to the support that they needed, but also responding to businesses. Really proud of how our Ferndale Chamber and our Downtown Development Authority responded to our businesses during the response and recovery now that we're in. So that was my first and foremost, you know, accomplishment, I think, for the city. And we're still in it and we're still navigating it. I said when I ran for mayor in 2019 that I would champion our city to become a carbon neutral city. And I started off on that path right away and joined the ICLE, which is the Local Government for Sustainability, and they help cities globally identify a science-based target to lower carbon in their communities or greenhouse gases, and then support their climate action planning process and identifying strategies. So the city council started investing in the greenhouse gas inventory prior to 2020, but it was completed in early 2020. And now we are starting the climate action planning process. I'm really proud to be asked to be a mayor to help other mayors join this effort in the US, and have been talking to White House staff and elected leaders at the national level through this program and our partnership with ICLE. So I'll continue to focus on this effort with city council and staff going forward. Also that happened in 2020 is that city council adopted the affordable and inclusionary housing plan. This has been started in 2018 and gone through in 2019, but the adoption of the plan, this really gives us the data about our housing challenges and the strategies and tactics that the city needs to do going forward as an intervention partner, because that's what cities need to do when new development comes in their city, is one of the, you know, sort of like spokes of the hub, what we can do to address. So we're looking at all of them, all of the spokes and hubs for housing in our community, and we'll be having those conversations going forward with our residents and business owners. And then finally, the challenge of the homeless and panhandling individuals underneath the 8 Mile Woodward underpass, making sure that we built a compassionate and human-centered approach to addressing their needs, as we also address the concerns expressed by not only the Ferndale neighborhood on the north side, but also the concerns of the Detroit neighborhood on the south side. And really supportive of the city council coming together with Detroit and saying, hey, let's make an investment. And so the city of Ferndale has put in $100,000 to do capital improvements around lighting to improve safety, as well as beautify the underpass with a mural, and then the city of Detroit is leveraging $100,000 to help pay for the human services. So this is where finding partnerships with your neighborhood communities. Detroit has a homeless department and has expertise on staff, and we've been leveraging their support to provide outreach to the individuals there, along with two nonprofits who are supporting this project as well. So lots going on. I think at the end of it, how much we've accomplished and worked on over the 2 years while during a pandemic, I know staff is exhausted and council can feel that way as well, but these are all important things that needed to get done, even though this pandemic had sidetracked a lot of us.
So what are some of the things that you'd like to work on moving forward?
Well, some of them are ongoing that was started in the pandemic, and one of them is the lead line replacement. It's an issue in older communities like ours when older homes have lead lines from the curb to the house. And the city council has prioritized funding the replacement of these lead lines. And this is going to be an ongoing funding, revisiting how much we're completing each year and how much money can we afford to do going forward. What I do know is that the residents have asked us to do more than what the state has advised of 7% per year. And so we're looking at how to accelerate that and get that done before the 20 years are over, because that's the timeline by the state law, is that all the lead lines have to replace in a 20-year period. We'd like to do that sooner. Some other initiatives that I have been very supportive about is making safety improvements on Woodward. I have said for years that the number one complaints I get are about the unsafe conditions that people walking, biking, even driving feel along Woodward. Only 6% of the 200 feet of Woodward is dedicated to people walking on the sidewalk, and there are no safe dedicated lanes for people who are rolling, whether it's rollerblading, biking, have a wheelchair to go in a dedicated protected lane. And then drivers are always complaining how hard it is to see turning right onto Woodward off of a side street, how hard it is to see oncoming traffic coming one way and then not seeing the walkers or bikers coming the other way because you're looking at oncoming traffic. These are all unsafe conditions that the Woodward Safety Improvement Project would help do, but really this is MDOT's project. It's in their control, and they have not yet decided at this day today on October 20th whether or not they're going to move forward with that project. But it's something that I've been working on for over 12 years, and this is our window of opportunity or leverage of opportunity to get this done.
So can you tell us a bit about your professional background and what skills you bring to the table?
Sure. I have a master's degree in urban planning, a certificate in project management from the Project Management Institute, and recently, during the pandemic year, I got certified as a climate change professional through the Association of Climate Change Officers. I was given a scholarship opportunity to complete that, and so it fit really well into being a leader in the carbon neutral space for cities. But I have been in the nonprofit, economic development, sort of community development, nonprofit space for the last 15 years, and I am a nonprofit executive and do consulting on the side in the philanthropic nonprofit space.
So what are some of the ways that you've been involved in the community?
Well, I've been elected for 12 years, and I always start with how I got started, because this is how anybody's pathway to getting elected starts, and that is volunteering with a board or commission or one of our many nonprofits like Ferndale Pride or FernCare, or affirmations to get involved, whether it's through a festival or giving insight and ideas to your local government. And I started on the Downtown Development Authority. I was going through grad school and I wanted to become a better urban planner. So I spent 5 years in the biz development community or committee for the DDA. Former Mayor Bob Porter appointed me to the Zoning Board of Appeals all before I got elected. And then once I got elected, I did all of the liaison responsibilities, Planning Commission, BZA, Ferndale, Environmental Sustainability Commission. So I have a real good idea of how the city functions and always looking forward how to improve everything for our residents and businesses.
So in this race, there's nobody else on the ballot, but there is a write-in candidate for this position. Why should the voters re-elect you?
Well, I definitely have, I think, proven that I am a dedicated public servant. I take it very seriously. I think local government, what we do and how we design our communities is how we, it impacts how we live. And I have been fortunate that the voters keep electing me to represent them and our values and interests as a community. And I think that's what sets me apart. Some things that people may not know about me is that I am a continuous learner. I will always dive in and read the reports and do the homework and reach out to organizations to see how I can be a better advocate or understand the issue in a different way so that I can bring more resources, partnerships, or ideas to the city and the community to consider. It's not always easy. And it takes time and dedication to walk through those processes this time, but they're important to do.
So if the voters want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
Oh, well, first I would invite you to visit my website at melaniepiana.com. And that has all the information, what I've been involved in the last 2 years, well, actually 10 years. And you can visit me on Facebook at Mayor Piana for Mayor. I'm on Twitter and have been for like 8 years, and you can check out Mel Piana for that. And I'm on Instagram, and I'm Melamint P on Instagram, and I just joined TikTok and I'm having a ton of fun, and I am Meltropolis Downtown on TikTok.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for doing the interview with us today.
Thanks, Crystal. I really appreciate it. Thanks for your time. And vote for me on November 2nd, folks. Look forward to representing your interests going forward for another 2 years. Thank you.